Hello everyone. Welcome to the second session of lesson 25.
Hello everyone. It's good to be back with you again.
朋友们好，今天是第25课的第二讲。在这一讲中，我们先要做课文的问答练习，然后我要来讲一讲形容词和副词的比较级以及最高级。另外呢，我们还要讲讲比较结构。最后，我们还要学习一下对话。Now, here are the questions. The first question, how many continents are there in the world? What are their names? How many continents are there in the world? What are their names?
There are seven. They are Asia, Africa, North America, South America,Europe, Oceania, and Antarctica. There are seven. They are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Oceania, and Antarctica.
Which continent is the largest and which is the smallest?Which continent is the largest and which is the smallest?
Asia is the largest and Oceania is the smallest. Asia is the largest and Oceania is the smallest.
How is Europe compared with Asia in the text? How is Europe compared with Asia?In the text,
Europe is only one-fourth the size of Asia. It is so much smaller than Asia that some geographers regard Europe as a peninsula of Asia. Europe is only one-fourth the size of Asia. It is so much smaller than Asia that some geographers regard Europe as a peninsula of Asia.
What forms the dividing line between Europe and Asia according to many geographers? What forms the dividing line between Europe and Asia according to many geographers?
The Ural Mountains form the dividing line between Europe and Asia. The Ural Mountains form the dividing line between Europe and Asia.
What do all geographers agree? What do all geographers agree?
They all agree that Asia was once linked to North America. They all agree that Asia was once linked to North America.
What do geographers say about the ancestors of American Indians?What do geographers say about the ancestors of American Indians?
They say that the ancestors of American Indians were Asians. 30,000 years ago, they went across the land bridge and settled down in new homes. They say that the ancestors of American Indians were Asians. 30,000 years ago,They went across the land bridge and settled down in new homes.
What canal separates Africa from Asia? When was it cut? What canal separates Africa from Asia? When was it cut?
The Suez Canal separates Africa from Asia. It was cut in 1869.The Suez Canal separates Africa from Asia. It was cut in 1869.
What is the name for the highest mountains in the world? And how high is the peak? What is the name for the highest mountains in the world? And how high is the peak?
The Himalaya Mountains. The peak is over 8,848 meters above sea level. The Himalaya Mountains. The peak is over 8,848 meters above sea level.
What makes the climbing of the peak so difficult? What makes the climbing of the peak so difficult?
The air is very thin and the weather is uncertain. The air is very thin and the weather is uncertain.
Can you explain why people take great pride in getting to that peak? Can you explain why people take great pride in getting to that peak?
Yes, I think I can. As the climbing is so difficult, it calls for great courage. Yes, I think I can. As the climbing is so difficult, it calls for great courage.
What are the three great religions of the world? And what places did they originate from, respectively? What are the three great religions of the world? And what places did they originate from, respectively? 后半句问题的意思是，这三大宗教分别起源于哪些地方？ Respectively 意思是分别的。
They are Buddhism, Christianity, and Islam. Buddhism originated from India. Christianity from Palestine, and Islam from Arabia. They are Buddhism, Christianity, and Islam. Buddhism originated from India. Christianity from Palestine, and Islam from Arabia.
How often do the Asian Games meet?How often do the Asian Games meet?
The Asian Games meet every 4 years. The Asian Games meet every 4 years.
What is the task for most of the Asian countries today? What is the task for most of the Asian countries today? Task, 意思是任务。
Their task is to catch up in science and technology. Their task is to catch up in science and technology. Well, that's all for the questions and answers on the text. Yiling will explain some grammar points to you shortly.
We 们先来讲讲形容词的比较级和最高级。形容词的比较级和最高级的规则形式有两种，一种是形容词比较级加词尾 er， 最高级加词尾 est， 另一种呢是在形容词前加 more 和 most。 一般来讲，单音节形容词词尾加 er 或者 est。 我们来看一些例子。
Long, longer, longest.
如果形容词的词尾是以不发音的字母 e 结尾，只要加 r 和 st 就可以了。比如
large, larger, largest. Free, freer.Freest
以重读闭音节结尾的形容词，词尾如果是一个辅音字母，要双写这一辅音字母，然后再加 er 和 est， 比如
big、bigger、biggest。
多音节形容词在变成比较级和最高级的时候，要在词前加上 more 和 most， 比如
important、more important、most important。
多数双音节形容词既可以加 er、est， 也可以在词前加 more和 most。 我们来看一下例子。
clever、 cleverer or more clever、 cleverest or most clever。
有两类双音节形容词一般采用加词尾 er 和 est 这样的形式。一类呢是以y 结尾的双音节形容词，比如
happy、 happier、 happiest。
请大家注意，这里在加词尾的时候，先要变 y 为 i， 然后再加 er 和 est。 另一类是以字母 ow 结尾的双音节形容词，比如
narrow、 narrower、 narrowest。
副词的比较级和最高级的规则形式和形容词的相似，单音节的副词呢一般要加词尾 er 和 est， 比如
hard、 harder、 hardest、 fast、 faster、 fastest。
以 ly 结尾的副词以及一些表示频度的副词呢，一般采用加 more 和 most 这样的形式，比如
carefully、more carefully、 most carefully、 often、 more often、 most often。
除了规则形式的比较级和最高级以外呢，少数形容词和副词也有不规则的形式，下面我们来看两个例子。
good、 better、best、 well、 better、 best、 many、 more、 most、 much、 more、 most。
好，刚才我们讲了形容词和副词的比较级以及最高级的构成形式，下面呢我们接着讲讲比较结构。英语中的比较结构主要采取三种形式，下面我们分别做一下说明。第一种形式呢是形容词或者副词的比较级加 than， 用于两者之间的比较。我们来看一下例句。
He is 3 years older than I am。
他比我大三岁。
This book is more interesting than that one.
这本书比那本书更有趣儿。
She plays the piano better than I thought.
她的钢琴弹得比我想象的要好。这里的 better 是副词 well 的比较级形式。
It rains more often in summer than in autumn.
夏天比秋天雨下得多。这种形式的比较结构 还常常可以和某些修饰语连用。修饰语呢，要放在比较级的前面。我们来看一下例句。
She looks much younger than she really is.
她看起来比她实际年龄要年轻得多。
I got up a bit earlier today than usual.
我今天比往常要起得稍早一些。比较结构的第二种形式是 as 加上形容词或副词的原级再加 as， 这种结构也用于两者之间的比较，比如
The wall is as white as snow，
这面墙白得像雪。
He has drunk as much coffee as I have.
他喝的咖啡和我一样多。
Do you speak English as well as the others?
你英语说的和那些人一样好吗？这个结构的否定比较要用 not as as 或者 not so as 这样的形式表示不如。好，我们来看一下例句。
She is not as tall as her sister.
她长得不如她妹妹高。
He doesn't write to his parents so often as his brothers do.
她给父母写信不如她的兄弟们那么勤。这第二种形式的比较结构也可以和某些修饰语连用。我们来看一下例句。
This room is twice as big as that one.
这个房间有那个房间的两倍那么大。
She sings almost as beautifully as the singer.
她几乎和那个歌唱家唱的一样好。第三种形式的比较结构呢，是形容词或者副词的最高级加上比较范围，比如
The Sahara is the biggest desert in the world.
撒哈拉沙漠是世界上最大的沙漠。注意，形容词最高级前通常必须加冠词 the。
He works the hardest of all.
他工作比谁都努力。注意，副词的最高级前冠词 the 可以加也可以不加。最高级的比较结构同样也可以和某些修饰语连用，比如
This is by far the best film I've seen.
这是我看过的电影中确确实实最好的一部。
Which country is the second most populous in the world?
哪个国家是世界上的第二人口大国？
Well, that's all for the grammar. Now we'll turn to the dialogue. Right, now we shall read the dialogue to you. Please listen carefully.
现在我们为大家来念对话，请仔细听。
Dialogue, back from vacation.
Glad you are back. We missed you during the vacation. How have you been?
Fine, thanks. I had a wonderful time at home. I did quite a bit of reading. Did you have a good time at school?
We certainly did. We saw quite a few excellent films. During the Spring Festival, we visited many places. We had a get-together with many old friends.
So we all had a fine vacation. And now we must get down to some good, solid work.
现在我来讲解一下对话中的语言点。
We missed you during the vacation.
意思是假期里我们很想念你。Miss 在这里是想念的意思。
Vacation 是指一年中定期的休假，
比如暑假可以说 summer vacation， 寒假 winter vacation。 那么在度假英文怎么说呢？
Be on vacation. Be on vacation.
熟人或朋友之间在隔了一段时间后见面时可以这样问候对方。
How have you been? How have you been?
如果是常见面可以用下面这样的问候语。
How are you?How are you? How's everything with you? How's everything with you? How are you doing? How are you doing?
对于这样的问候语，回答的时候可以这样说。
Fine, thanks. Very well, thank you. Not bad.
对话中有这样一句话
I did quite a bit of reading，
意思是我读了不少书。如果不需要特别指明读什么东西，英语中就可以说
Do some reading， Do some reading。
Get together 是一个合成词，意思是团聚或者联欢会。那么家庭团聚怎么说呢？
A family get togetherA family get together.
如果家庭成员从不同的地方回到家中团聚，可以这样说。
Have a family reunion. Have a family reunion.
过完一个愉快的假期，该踏踏实实地做些事情了。那么这个意思在对话中是这样表达的。
And now we must get down to some good solid work.
Get down to 是一个动词短语，意思是开始认真的对待或做事情。To 在这里是介词。Good 在这里表示强调，意思是十足的，非常的。Good.在英语中是一个意思非常灵活的词，我们来看一些例子。
A good investment. A good investment.
可靠的投资。
A good reason. A good reason.
充足的理由。
A good contract. A good contract.
有效的合同。Good.还可以和其他一些词构成口语中的常用短语，比如
Good for you. Good for you.
干得好。
It's no good. It's no good.
这没用。由于时间关系呢，我们不再念第二遍对话了，请朋友们课后阅读物主代词的绝对形式及其句法作用以及 word study 部分。Well, that's it for today. Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye, everyone. Join us again.